Is this going? It is. Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to the YouTube channel. So I'm gonna run you guys through a back workout today. I'm doing like a back workout mostly for like upper back thickness. And do like a voiceover. Addy's chilling right over there. Watching, I don't know, what's this guy's name again? Yeah, and like kind of teach you something as we go along. But right now I'm gonna be mixing up pre-workout. So I'm doing, I'll grab it from my bag here. Okay, pre-workout we got, you gotta fill it with water first. Bloodshot. And half scoop of Intra R3 for pre-workout. So I'm doing 2 scoops of Bloodshot. So as many of you guys know, this is the, forgot what I was saying. This is the pump pre-workout from House That Sucked. Bro, there's cops coming by this house every day. Or no, it's an ambulance, never mind. This is one of my favorites, guys. This is insane. My favorite flavor is definitely the watermelon candy. And then Intra R3 Orange is goated. This shit is insane. I like the orange a lot better. So half a scoop with my Bloodshot. Like, I know it tastes better if I did like the watermelon flavor of Intra R3 with the Bloodshot watermelon candy, but I'm not a big fan of the watermelon flavor. The oranges taste really good. So I'm gonna mix this up, take it down. It's about like a 15-20 minute drive to the gym, and then film like the top sets of my working sets or something, and do like the voiceover on that. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the video, and I'll see you guys at the gym. She's rolling. Okay, what's going on, guys? So we're here at Metro. Mike is on. Okay, good. And doing like an upper back focused back day today. You know, I like to split my back workouts up into 2 days. One upper back day, but with like one lat movement at the end. I don't know why my headphones are on my head like this. One lat movement at the end, and then my second back day in my split is like mostly a lat focused back day. And then at the end, possibly throw in like a couple light sets of back, you know, just still get both, or not of back. Couple light sets of an upper back exercise, just to still get blood in the area, kind of like just like feeder set type shit. Do the voiceover. I'm just gonna get into the fucking voiceover. Jesus. Addy and I are gonna both do the voiceover probably, and we are here with Victoria.
Hello.
That was your debut right there. That was your YouTube debut.
Bro, I haven't seen my armpit.
Oh my god, I'm putting that in there. Damn. Yeah, let's run it up.
By pulling with your elbow, okay? So, fully stretch. You want to keep your shoulder blades close together. Come back with your elbow.
Welcome back to the video. I don't know why I said welcome back to the video when you guys have already been on the video. Well, welcome back to my first voiceover. This is a little different. I'm running you guys through a back workout. Right now, you see me doing these rope pullovers. These, I love these. I start every back day with these. I warm up my upper body days, like even when I'm hitting chest and shoulders or whatever. I start with these. I just love getting my posterior chain pumped up as well. Even when I'm doing like a push day, like chest or something like that. Because I really like having my whole upper body warm, getting my shoulders moving. But some cues that I think about with this movement is I want to keep my lats loaded in the stretched position. What you can get out of a loaded stretch in terms of the contraction and benefits, like the results you're going to get through loading the muscle in a fully stretched and contracted position is insane. And I just think about driving my elbows back towards my hips, squeezing my lower lats, and trying to squeeze my shoulder blades together as well. Keep my chest high. Exercise number 2 is going to be barbell seal row. I like using it with this barbell. I honestly knew the name of this barbell, but I cannot remember it off the top of my head. And you'll see, oh man, damn messages. You'll see here, I'm pulling the weight up. I'm trying to pull it with my elbows coming out with a slight bend towards my butt and pulling with my elbows, squeezing everything in my upper back and squeezing my scapula together, my shoulder blades together. And I'm really trying to focus in on controlling my negative and having a loaded stretch at the bottom and squeezing at the top. I like to think about this movement as the first initial start of the movement is going to be contracting my scapula, squeezing my back, my upper back, and then pulling with my elbows. I want to have very little bicep activation in this, and I don't want to get the weight up by flexing my biceps. So I like to keep the weight. Seth Ferosi thinks about it this way when he's doing his pulling movements. I like to keep the weight on the outsides of my hands, like my ring finger and my pinky finger, because those are your weakest fingers, and I do the majority of the pulling with those fingers because I don't want my strong fingers taking over, then my grip comes into play. So what I'm doing here is, honestly, I forgot exactly how many sets and reps I was doing, but I think I was only working up to two working sets. This right here, I believe, is my first working set. I'm just trying to, right now, get the feel for the movement. I like to zone in and imagine what my body is doing when I'm doing every single rep. That really helps my mind-muscle connection. Right there, starting off with good, consistent tempo of each rep. And then when it starts to get to the point where I can't get the weight up anymore and secondary and tertiary muscles are starting to take over and I'm like getting my chest up off the bench and I'm not using primarily my upper back to pull the weight up, then I'm done. Now I'm going to strip the weight. This is my last working set, that's right. So I do a double drop set on here. So I strip the weight and I do two more sets to failure. Sometimes I do like a cluster set. So now I'm just doing the 25s and it feels super heavy just because I'm so fatigued. And it really, when you contract the muscle as hard as you can every single rep, it makes that set so much more intense. I hate when people think that the only way to make your workouts more intense is by decreasing rest time between sets and doing a shit ton of supersets. In all reality, yes, your workout might be insane, like you might be getting a great sweat going, but your body needs time to rest between sets, especially when you're training high intensity with low amount of sets and training until failure, muscular failure. I probably could have cranked out a couple more on this set, honestly. Now you're just looking at my butt here. Now I'm just slapping on some 10s to the bar, but you guys get the drift. Moving on to the next exercise. Exercise number two is going to be a seated wide / medium-ish grip cable row. These have been done wonders for my upper back. I used to only focus on my lats because I thought that like lats was where I was lacking. I didn't really care about my upper back when it came to like rhomboids, traps, and I don't even know all the names of the muscles in your upper back, but I would like neglect it. You know, I'd probably do like one or two movements every other, like a couple of weeks, you know, targeting specifically upper back. This movement here really helped my upper back development, and I get a crazy mind muscle connection. So what I'm thinking about is not gripping the bar super tight with this movement. I want to be
so it's a workout. I like to do my other half. I don't even know if you can hear me hit the mic, that's this far away, but other half of intra R3 carbohydrates. And then one scoop of silanine EAAs. I don't even know if that's recording. I don't even know if I checked. Is there a red dot? Oh, okay, bad. And one scoop of silanine. And this is like always after my first working exercise, not after my warm-ups. That's when I start mixing these and simping on it, and then I finish it like probably after this exercise.
Again, like the seal rows, I want to be pulling with my ring and my pinky, sometimes my middle finger, and I want to be driving my elbows out. But if you can see here at the start of the movement, I'm driving my elbows back behind me. As in my head, I'm thinking I want to drive my elbows back as far as I can while squeezing my scapula, while squeezing my shoulder blades together and having a loaded stretch at the bottom, just like that. This is my top set for my wide grip, medium grip, whatever you want to call it, seated cable row. Squeezing my upper back as hard as I can, controlling the negative. Right here, I pull, I'm flexing my back. And the first thing that moves on the way back of lowering the weight on the eccentric is my shoulder blades. It's not pushing my arms forward. I'm not contracting my upper back anymore. I'm squeezing, retracting my upper back, letting the weight come forward while still loading it. All right, next exercise is going to be these chest-supported dumbbell rows. These aren't really the Jansen rows that I was trying to do, because with this bench, honestly, and how the pressure it puts on my sternum, it was really uncomfortable and I really don't like it. For some reason, it hurts my shoulders too. And I think it's just the way my back is arching over the bench or whatever. So if I'm not doing like a Jansen row, then I'm doing just a chest supported dumbbell row like this. And I'm not trying to squeeze my lats here. I'm trying to drive the elbows out away from each other and squeeze my upper back. And I believe this here is the last exercise, but we just got this new machine in it. It's similar to a pit shark, but it's kind of like a cheaper belt squat, but I still love it because you can get a crazy upper back contraction out of it. And these, I believe I was just doing, I think just three sets of 15, and I was supersetting it with rope pullovers, I believe, for around 15 to 20 reps as well. This was my first time actually hitting this machine with the V-bar attached to it, and it really hit. So if you guys have a belt squat like this, a Pitchart belt squat, or even a Westside Barbell belt squat, man, I can't talk. You guys have to try it. You got to play with where you're standing on the platform and where you're pulling from to get a really good contraction without having the bias be placed on anything else. Supersetting this with rope cable pullovers, just like I started. I believe I'm doing 15 to 20 reps here, focusing on a slow eccentric, squeezing my back, squeezing my lats, driving my elbows back towards my hips as far as possible, keeping a full loaded stretch at the top. And I didn't go all the way to the top here. I'm not sure why I did that, but I don't know. I notice flaws in my own lifting or my own training all the time. But this superset really killed me. I'm dead by the end of this workout. You probably just heard me playing the video because I'm doing this voiceover.
Oof, there we go. You don't even see me? Man, I am looking rough. That's for sure. But yo, okay. So that was the workout. I'm still doing biceps at the end, but I'm gonna end it here because I gotta quickly do biceps before a couple of my clients come in. So today was mostly an upper back focus day. Not a whole lot of volume. Two working sets on most exercises except chest supported dumbbell rows. Those are straight sets. And then one lat movement at the end, which is what you just saw when we supersetted it with the belt squat machine thing that we just got. I think it's dope as hell though. Man, you can't see me. There we go. So yeah, no, please like, comment, share, subscribe. And yeah.